and we'll move on to the final item. So we skip back actually to number seven, which is the road safety report. And again, just by way of introduction from me, again, it's a key priority within the police and crime plan. And there's no doubt that when we carry out public survey work and feedback from the community at various meetings and various sessions, road safety always comes out pretty much near the top. And obviously that can range from inconsiderate parking to dangerous driving to sadly death and serious injury on the roads. And it is something we are looking to pursue moving forward with the West Yorkshire Combined Authority as we move through the devolution transition into the mayoral combined authority. We are trying to adopt what's called a Vision Zero approach, and I've already had some conversations with the chair of the combined authority, Councillor Susan Hinchcliffe, leader of Bradford Council. And we also work very closely with the national road safety charity Brake, who are actually based in West Yorkshire but do some excellent work with West Yorkshire Police, but supporting bereaved victims of deaths on our roads, sadly. And you know, the family liaison officers are clearly a key part of all that, and the very specialist role that they carry out. And of course, I also lead on the automatic number plate recognition work for police and crime commissioners. And again, we've invested very heavily in that over the years in West Yorkshire. And you know, clearly always looking to progress and make best use of that. So, following that intro from me, I'm going to hand back to West Yorkshire Police just to give a quick overview around this report, and then we'll finish off with some questions. Thank you.
So, in summary, then, we're going to be touching on the update in respect of our response to delivering Vision Zero. We're going to pick up the update around the dash cam and community reporting, a focus on partnerships. We'll touch on what you just mentioned around ANPR, and we also want to give a bit of an update in terms of performance, particularly around the reduction in collisions, but accepting that's against the backdrop of COVID-19. But also touching on some of the key themes falling out of the backdrop of COVID-19 with ultra speeders. And again, we just want to raise your awareness, and in particular the awareness of the public around the increasing trend of drug driving. And again, we'll touch on the numbers of individuals killed on our roads, sadly, across West Yorkshire to date, which is 32. And I'd just make the point that one is one too many. And on that sad note, over to yourself, please, Ed.
Thanks, sir. Thanks, Commissioner. Good to see you. I hope you're well. So, good to hear, obviously, about the mayoral engagement as we move to that model, because I think it's Vision Zero is in various stages of adoption across the county, but I don't think there's any doubting the commitment to that. Having sat on the Safer Roads Executive, chaired by Mr. Julian Jackson at Bradford, a week and a half ago. So it's clearly uppermost in everybody's thinking. So trying to keep it to the headlines then, collisions for 2019, we are doing comparatively well, but that comes with that asterisk at the bottom of the page in relation to the impact of COVID and quieter roads. So just by way of example then, although the concern long term is around the number of KSIs plateauing, we have seen a sharp decrease this year. So casualties from the beginning of the first lockdown period to current date, at the time of this report submission, was 1,906 compared to 2,809 at the same stage in 2019. So I think that's fairly evident, a reduction of almost 900. But again, it does come with that narrative around COVID, and then data around actual casualties, fatalities, is 32 people so far in 2020 compared to 52 in the whole of 2019. Accepting that we're a fortnight off the end of the year, so again, down by 20 exactly at the time of the report submission. But again, with that footnote around COVID impact. In respect to Vision Zero then, and the strategic drive behind it, prior to a week and a half ago, SRE had last met on the 21st of May. And I suppose most people would appreciate that that was mostly due to pandemic restrictions. But clearly the paper was set out in terms of the overall strategic objective. And I suppose I'm pleased to report that in the recent days, and again, this was reiterated at the SRE very recently, Leeds especially have made some significant ground in terms of adopting that as the strategic plan. And then through local delivery and partnership work, they've clearly got their teeth stuck into that, for want of a better phrase. So I suppose the trick for the rest of the force in conjunction with its partnerships will be replicating that approach across the rest of the county. But I've no doubt that everybody firmly grasps the principles of Vision Zero. And I guess I suppose the trick will be coordinating the partnership activity to drive that. I suppose I'm not, I'm being realistic to understand the sort of resource and financial constraints around partnership resources. We said quite strongly in the SRE a week and a half ago that this is certainly the time to come closer together in terms of communication, smarter working and intelligent-led responses to identified hotspots. I suppose just on that note, to round that one off, I think the single biggest point for improvement, whilst we have a good tasking mechanism in place, a lot of it is based on historic data, and there is a real joint agreement and consensus around the need to further improve the information product, so that we have live time analysis and tasking capability. And by way of example, in recent days, the crash system will be on the threshold of going live. That gives us a live time analytical picture of collision and casualty data. But also reaching out to partners, we're also now aware of various intelligence products that give us a much more informed picture of where our problem issues are. And I think that there's a huge sell in that, in terms of being smart about where we do deploy our precious resource to maximum impact. So next item then was the Dashcam submissions portal. In summary, launched on the 1st of July 2020, it is a huge success story. I think Paul Jeffrey explained this morning, actually at SLT, that the numbers of submissions were well into the hundreds, approaching 1,000. And as a result of that, we've had at least 100 successful prosecutions now. I suppose the issue for us going forward will be the continued positive marketing of that. We engaged with Bradford last week, and it will be about driving awareness, because as much as we think we've done a good marketing job to date, there was some unawareness there. But equally, and this shows the value of partnership work, equally, we were educated around some of the more nuanced communication channels that within that district specifically. There's a shared commitment to increasing the uptake of dash cams. I think there will be a proactive seek for funds to provide that to some of the wider public. And then we would reasonably anticipate to see an uplift in those submissions. So all in all, a good news story there, but with more to do. AMPR, I suppose, Commissioner, if I can just give you some headline figures, really, because I know you lead the APCC group on AMPR, and it's very close to your heart. It continues to be a success story for us. So I suppose, despite the ongoing discussions around the transition from our NADC system to the NAS, and without labouring this particular meeting with the intricacies of that, we know that there are some significant issues and concerns with the operational capability of NAS, which in itself explains why we will have to run NADC concurrently for some time to come. And with that, it brings some financial considerations, obviously. But certainly within West Yorkshire, and hence the value of continuing to run NADC, the operational capability and delivery on that remains significant. So To date for 2020, there have been attributable to ANPR 990 arrests, 23 missing people found, and we're just on the threshold of recovering 1,500 vehicles, and that was as of this morning. The main beneficiaries of ANPR on a proactive footing are our proactive intercept team, who have just edged over 1,300 arrests since their inception in April 2018, with over 1,600 vehicle seizures. And actually, since August 2020, have now accumulated £100,000 worth of criminal cash seizures, along with £810,000 worth of drugs commodities seized, and that is in the last 4 months. The success rate for intelligence research packages linked to ANPR is at 78%, although I would say that of the task packages sent out, we get round to stopping about 40% of those. So the success rate for those that we do stop is very high. I think with smarter and increased capability, the results are unlimited, really, because the value is being proved time and time again. Quick couple of lines then on the impact of COVID-19. I think I've already referred to the strategic partnership and SRE side of things was inevitably impacted upon during the better part of the year. But that is back on track as of a week and a half ago, as I've already said. There were some, and I'm sure we've probably all experienced this, some technical issues with the sort of virtual meeting technology. So I suppose it's a fair summary to say that business has slowed down, but I'm really quite confident and optimistic that we're working through that and coming out the other side as we head into 2021. Unless there's any questions on any of that, Commissioner, at the moment, I'll just pause there.
Well, do you want to just conclude whatever you want to say on the rest of the report, Ed, and I'll come in at the end?
Yeah, sure thing. So the last couple of items on my list here are the overarching road safety partnership. We are continuing to do a lot of education and engagement work, ranging from road safety inputs into schools, again funded through partnerships, and that is obviously with the early intervention theme close at heart. Media marketing coverage continues to be a focal point, although I've already said that we do need to explore the wider reach of probably some less obvious media channels that operate at a really local level, and we just need to improve our awareness of those. On the camera partnership side, there has obviously been some impact again from a partnership aspect due to the pandemic, but Paul Jeffrey would explain quite succinctly that the camera enforcement unit has continued obviously to enforce speed limits throughout the roads of the county on behalf of the partnership. And albeit there have been reduced traffic volumes during phases of the lockdown and tier restrictions, we have seen proportionate drivers taking that opportunity to exceed the speed limit. Mr. Foster referred earlier to ultra speeders, which was an unwelcome phenomenon attributable to the lockdown period, where quieter roads generally did lead to them almost being used as a racetrack at times. However, year-to-date offences captured by cameras and other means of enforcement are achieving some really positive results. I suppose the last point of note on that is we are obviously commissioning the phasing in of new digital cameras to replace the obsolete wet film equipment, and that is an ongoing initiative. Just to conclude then, I think the partnership and drive of the strategy across the county is still very much there. Strategic Roads Partnership Board last week, which is separate to the SRE, has some really positive updates from districts in terms of their grasp of the overarching plan and what they're doing to combat that. But I suppose I would just caveat that with the statement from earlier on that we do, in my view, need to improve the information product, but that can only be a better thing for the work that we deliver, albeit we are achieving some fantastic results as it stands. In conclusion, Commissioner, I think it's Just on being the month of December, it is the MPCC seasonal drink drug drive campaign, which I know is it is an emotive time for a large proportion of people who sadly suffered loss at this time of year. It is again very different this year for a number of reasons. I suppose from our perspective, there have been some astonishing results really from the first fortnight of December. For drink and drug driving, we have this afternoon reached 166 arrests, and in line with very recent trends, drug driving related arrests have exceeded drink driving related arrests, and that's probably for the second month in succession now. With that comes some challenges around toxicology and the speed with which we can process the arrests and turn them into successful prosecutions. There has been an impact on the forensic capability to turn that round, but they themselves have a plan to deal with that, which is being put into effect now, just so we can avoid the spectre of statutory limitations precluding some people from being rightly prosecuted. We have been really clear, however, that despite those issues with toxicology capability, that clearly will not stop us doing the job that we need to do in terms of keeping the road safe and enforcing, as we always would do, to make sure that people across the county are as safe as they can be. And I think, Commissioner, by exception, they are the main headlines.
Yeah, thank you very much for that update, and again, recognise the good work that's ongoing. And as you know, without getting into some of the intricacies, aware of some of the sort of funding and technical issues, particularly in relation to ANPR. But I think that's probably a question for another day. Which I will need to take up with you anyway outside of this particular forum. And obviously noted the good work on the current campaign around the drink drug driving, and clearly we've got to put the COVID factor as an asterisk throughout all this, as you sort of alluded to as well, with regards to perhaps some of the behaviours that we are seeing, and yes, of course, I was aware of the issue of boy racers, shall we say, that was the term used to me by a number of people across West Yorkshire who have been in touch through some of the casework. So, thank you for raising that. Just a couple of questions to finish off.
Sure.
The first one is, as you've said, the early indications from the digital submissions portal on the webcams, dash cam, sorry. Would you like to make any further comments around how the public might be able to assist further with that?
Yeah, I think I alluded there in the update to awareness, really. As much as we think we're doing a good job, and I do think we are doing a good job in marketing it, clearly there is a wider section of society that we can reach out to in that respect. So we will be looking at the availability of the marketing in multilingual formats. But as I said there are some social media channels and local communication channels that really are, I wouldn't say obscure, but they are well, reasonably well unknown, if I can be honest. So, in our discussion with Bradford last week, they were talking about a particular community group who had a really extensive reach into their local community, and this was a readership and listenership of around several thousand people, which to date would be untapped by ourselves. So I think that's the main thing for us, and by progressing that and exploring funding options to provide the public with dash cam capability, albeit again another part of it will promoting just how accessible and relatively inexpensive the dash cams are, I think we can quickly start to work on improving the submissions rate well over the thousand that we're knocking on the door of. Bradford in itself was a bit of a surprise in terms of its proportionate rate of submissions. So out of the total, it represented 15%. And I think both experientially and anecdotally, Bradford does have a significant issue with antisocial and criminal use of the roads. So if there is a priority, it will be to market it more positively within Bradford and encourage the uptake there with the anticipated good results.
Yeah, no, well, if there's anything I can do to assist with that, please let me know. Very happy to do that. And then, you know, with regards to ANPR, I mean, clearly I'm aware of the delays to the national system, but it's really around, you know, in the meantime, what more can we do to fully utilise that technology, given the investment we've made in ANPR?
Yeah, we are really clear that if we were to lose the NADC capability in favour of NAS with its limitations at the moment, that would create some significant issues for us. So I suppose despite the financial concerns, we have lobbied hard to retain that dual capability, because I suppose it's fair to say that we do have a high degree of sophistication within West Yorkshire. So we will be maintaining a clear tone system. That gives us the excess capability in addition to the NAS system. Just to mitigate the costs there, we will be reducing some of the licenses around NADC to make sure that we have essential usership only. But just to make sure that we're maximising that, we do have fully fledged research capability within ANPR now, with the posts that were created being recruited to and now filled. As I alluded to earlier, that does give us a really significant capability in terms of creating packages which target our risk drivers, certainly around the fatal four aspects, of which primarily speed and drug driving are the predominant ones. And as I say, the return rate on those task packages is knocking on the door of 80%. That's 80%. So whatever we are creating is significantly valuable to operational teams, and they are returning a really good rate on that.
Yeah, no, thank you for that, Ed. And I guess some of that touches on potential problem solving approaches into that drug driving aspect as well.
Yeah, and that will obviously form the basis of our prevention and engagement and education strands of our plan, which are actually going through the early stages of refreshing that for 2021. But yeah, there will be a clear drive on the education side, certainly.
Yeah, and just by way of comment to finish off, you know, clearly, as I've already referenced, moving into the mayoral combined authority structures, there is, you know, as part of the wider devolution funding deal, there is potentially some resources that may be available for this wider investment into the Vision Zero, which may well include more investment into, you know, enforcement capability. So it's something that we absolutely need to be cited on and getting into dialogue about that as soon as possible, because there's no doubt the public see road safety and enforcement issues around road safety generally as a key issue. So, you know, and absolutely I do too, and obviously I need to reflect that as the Police and Crime Commissioner following the public survey work that we undertake.